12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
And on this week's show, first of all, we've got Movemint.
Such a massive buzz about this trick, and I've got to tell you right now, guys, I don't think I've been as interested in seeing a Paul Harris trick for a long time, and I'll tell you why. Many years ago, Paul Harris brought out something called Lip Smacker, and I had it, and I did it all the time. It was fantastic, and then I lost my Lip Smacker gimmicks, and it was discontinued. And
Craig, is this relevant?
Well, this is basically the evolution of Lip Smacker.
Oh, right, okay.
So, yes, kind of relevant.
Let's get it off the sticks.
Why not?
Can you do me a favour? Can you hold out your right hand, Craig? I'm going to give you one of these mints.
Yep.
And what I want you to do is just close your hand over the mint. There we go. But give it room to move, actually, inside your hand. But actually, hold that nice and tight. And this is the strange thing. If I bring my hand closer...
Oh, that's weird.
You can actually feel the mint move inside
your hand. Yeah, I can feel it moving in my hand.
Open your hand for a second. Yeah. You can see it there. There's nothing attached to that or anything like that.
No, there's not, no.
You did actually feel it move.
Yeah, yeah, it is.
Get really close there, John. And I want you to concentrate on that mint. Imagine that you can make it move with the power of your mind.
Isn't that
the strangest thing?
That's cool.
That is weird, isn't it? Now, before you had your hands actually closed, do me a favour. Close your hand again, but turn your hand over.
Okay.
And you can feel the mint inside there.
You can genuinely feel
it.
Yeah.
And you're going to feel it slowly start to disperse. The energy is removed from it. It's not going to move anymore because if you open your hand... It completely
disappears.
That's
cool. I love that.
How'd that look, John?
Yep.
Look good?
So, guys, what this is, you receive in this box a whole stack of really ingenious gimmicks. You don't just get a DVD in here.
There's some good stuff in there.
You get some amazing stuff in here. Now, there's a few different routines, all very well explained. There's one where you put a mint down on the table and you start to kind of blow air and the mint's like doing a kind of a PK thing and like flying all over the place.
Yeah.
And there's a lovely moment where you just push the mint forward to them and you let them eat it.
Yeah, just in the action of going like that and knocking the mint over means at that moment they can then eat
the mint. Yeah, and you get extra mints that you can give away, but they're easily accessible on the internet.
Yeah.
You can buy the mints very, very easily. The routine that I love best about this, they've got various things. They've got barehanded vanishes of mints. You've got the routine that Dave did, a whole bunch of different stuff. I like the PK stuff, but the reason that I think this is one of the coolest tricks to come out in a long time is the vanish of the mint in the spectator's
hand.
We had
this last week, first of all, didn't we? We had quite a heated discussion about this, whether it would actually work or not.
I knew it would because I did Lip Smacker.
You forced me into going and doing it on the guy over the road, in the electrical wholesale place across the road, and I did it, and his expression was like, do that again.
Yeah, exactly. Because here's the thing. As magicians, we make small objects vanish and they vanish in our hand. That's one thing. You can take that to a next level by having something vanish in the spectator's hand. So you can put like two coins in the spectator's hand and using some sort of coin gimmick, you can have two coins go into one, or you can have two sponge balls go into one or whatever. This is the only thing that I have ever seen in all my years in magic where you can take an object, put it in their hand, they close their hand.
A normal
object. Put it in their hand. They are convinced that it is in their hand. And trust me, guys, I was convinced. I felt that mint in my hand.
Yeah,
we performed it to the guy...
If you know somebody that's got this or you want to come in the shop and have it demmed on you, you really are convinced it's in your hand.
When you did it to the guy over the other side of the road...
There's something about the fact that it's still there.
He felt it moving in his hand.
Yeah,
he was
telling me it was moving, which is why I said about you'll feel it. Because people just volunteer the information.
And then in their hand, it vanishes and they're left with nothing. This is not a dual reality situation. This isn't he's an instant stooge. This is putting an ordinary object into a spectator's hand, having them close their hand and having it vanish. Forget about all the other stuff. All the other stuff is good. But for that reason alone, this is awesome.
I haven't worked it. But one thing I've changed is I get them to close their hand first.
I thought that was great, yeah.
So then they feel it moving in their hand, but they don't see it.
Yeah.
So then you get a progression of they see it moving.
Yeah.
And then when you're telling them to close their hand again, they've already had it in their hand once.
Yeah.
So I think it, for me, makes it a bit easier for them to close their hand the second time and get ready for the vanish.
Totally.
Sets themselves up. Do you know what? Although I love it, I'm still not convinced. I've seen the reaction.
You've seen the
reaction. I know. I'm still not convinced. I don't know what it is. It's I don't know if it's because it feels a bit like toy shop magic. I don't know, but
I like it. You know, you carry this around with you. You just carry your mints around with you, and you're good to go. You're ready to go into it.
The gimmicks are ingenious. There's so much more to it than what people think. The people just think the secret is this.
I referenced Lip Smacker earlier. If you saw the original Lip Smacker, this is nothing like the original Lip Smacker. This is, they've taken this gimmick, completely re-engineered it, completely come up with new concepts, and took it 1,000,000% in the other direction. It's ingenious. You carry this around with you. It's an almost instant reset. You're ready to go.
Yeah.
You can carry this around. You could go to, you can carry your mints around with you and be ready to perform a miracle anytime, anyway.
Worldwide shortage of these things at the moment, but it's all right. It's good. It's a lot better than I thought it was going to be.
It's
and
awesome.
Having used it twice, the reactions are very good when the mint vanishes from their hand and they're convinced it's still in there. I'll give it 89%.
In recent weeks, I've given a lot of stuff really high marks, but the reason is we're reviewing stuff that I'm using. I used Lip Smacker years ago. I'm going to use this. I have to give it 96%. I think it's brilliant. It's awesome. It's amazing. Okay, we've got another.
Do you know if we sit like this, it really annoys John because we look tiny.
Does it? We better not do that then. another. Another essential magic.
Is John
collection.
Going to appear this week and have another rant?
I don't know. No. That was John's first rant.
No.
Yeah. No. Have you downloaded Magic Spider yet, John? No. You gonna, John?
In fact, I've binned my web.
You've binned your web. Anyway, essential
that
magic.
That sounds like some ghetto speak. That's going to be the new thing. I've binned my web, man.
Are you down with the kids?
Yeah, I've binned my web.
Okay, fair enough. this is an award-winning routine, you know. This is a comedy card routine that helped Woody Aragon win first prize at the International Day of Magic in London 2011. We were there. He came up to us afterwards, if you remember.
It's
just after
did.
He reviewed the Book of English. I saw his act. It was awesome.
Yeah.
Fantastic act. I didn't realise this was in it. Obviously, didn't pay too much attention.
You were probably asleep.
I did get in trouble on the internet, didn't I, for falling asleep. Tired. I sleep a lot. And I fall asleep in lectures. And if I've ever fallen asleep in your lecture, I apologise.
It's because he's been up since 6 o'clock.
Sessioning.
That's when he comes alive.
That's the thing.
So you're going to do
this
it?
This is the Bumblebees. Yeah, you know what? How long ago did I open this, honestly?
Half an hour ago.
He challenged me to learn this in half an hour. I think I can do it. Get it off the sticks for me, John. It's called the Bumblebees. Dave, I have some.
Have you learnt the music? Can I
no. It? Oh, by the way, there is music to this. What he does is he does it to the Flight of the Bumblebees. You know, and you get the track on there. And he says he does it to music, or if he hasn't got the music, he hums it. I'm barely going to be able to do the move, so it ain't going to be hummed. I'm just going to just concentrate on actually doing the trick. so that's the way it is. So we've got some blank cards here, guys. Now, these cards, they're blank. They have nothing on them. These are what cards look like before they're printed. Just blank cards. I do have a picture of a bumblebee as well. I have a few pictures of bumblebees. You'll see what that's all about in a minute. You see, this trick is all about blank cards and bumblebees. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the bumblebees and I'm going to lay them out onto the table. Okay, so I'm going to put we'll put one there and one there. Okay,
yeah.
And I need another couple of bumblebees as well. Let me get a couple more. There we go. And I'll put shall I put that one there? Yeah, I'll put that one there. And this one I'm going to put right down here in front of me.
Okay,
now the blank cards, these aren't going to become important until later on. The blank cards are going to become important in a bit. I'm going to put one here. The other three I'm going to put there on top of that bumblebee. I'm going to put that bumblebee and those three blank cards in front of you.
Okay.
Okay. The other bumblebees I'm just going to put there. So we've got a situation where we've got three bumblebees.
Yeah.
And over here, you've got three blank cards and another bumblebee. Now, you've heard of the ace assembly, and we're going to try and do the same thing with bumblebees. And this is the bit where Woody goes... What we're going to do, I'm going to take these bumblebees one at a time. I'm going to take this one first of all. And the idea is that you watch this one. You see, if I just snap... Perfect. The first word, the first one goes. I'm going to try that again. We've got another two bumblebees to go. This time, you know exactly what's going to happen. I'm not going to hide it. I'm not going to put it in between the other two or anything. You're going to see it happen. Watch. All you have to do. There you go. That's perfect. That's the second one. That leaves us with one last one. Okay. We're going to put this one right here. I'm going to have it turned over the other way in the packet.
Yeah.
Okay. And it's going to go in slow motion. Now, look, let me show you. Nothing's actually happened yet. It doesn't happen until we do this. Sound effects. Thank you. And just like that, hopefully with any luck. Yeah, that's great. And we've got a situation now where we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 blank cards.
That is brilliant.
Hang on. Because down here, from the very beginning, do you remember this? Uh-oh. Did I just hit? Yeah, I think I might have hit it a little. Oh, I think I might have hit that just a little bit.
John loves that.
Whoops.
That's good, isn't it?
Come on. Are you impressed I actually managed to pull that off?
I can't
as well?
Believe he remembered all that.
That is a lot of sequence to remember in half an hour. I'm actually, Woody, if you're watching this, and I know you watch the show, I hope I did it justice, because literally, I just did it in half an hour. And I watched the performance, and I said to Dave, I can learn this in half an hour, and I did. But I'm telling you right now, that was probably a very ropey
performance. Can I just point out that the next trick I will dem on the show, I learned in half an hour as well.
Okay, very impressive. Is it as complicated as that? I felt like I was walking tightrope the entire time.
Be the judge when we do it.
I'm going to tell you something right now. I only learnt this half an hour ago, but you know what? I do less these days, but I still do quite a lot of family restaurants. And I think in a family restaurant, if you've got kids and families around, I think this routine would play
John's lucky. I think John, he's doing that thing with his chin where he thinks, I should do that. That's good.
Come on, this is a routine.
When John's going to use something, he does that with his chin. He's like, that can work for me.
Yeah, you know what? It's worked for me. The reset is almost instantaneous. Literally, all you have to do is gather the cards up and it's pretty much reset. The instructions on the DVD are very well explained.
When I watched it on the DVD, the ending came as a total surprise to me.
Yeah, yeah.
And I laughed, and just like you did, John, I thought, that's good. It's a shock, the ending, isn't it?
Yeah, and look at how clean the end display is. You know, you got all these... hope you flashed something there. You got all these cards here, and it just looks completely and totally, you know, like... It's just amazing. It really is. It's not actually that hard to do.
It's brilliant.
It's not actually that hard to do. There's a few simple moves in there. There's a couple of false counts. Nothing difficult. Nothing beyond beginner to intermediate level. The one thing is there's a lot. It's move after move after move after move. So you have to kind of spend a while learning.
But
the
music,
structure
when
of the
he uses the music, it does make it entertaining.
It really
How much
does.
Are you going to give it?
I'm. You know what's going in my act? I'm definitely going to do it. I love
Everything
it.
Everything goes in your act. So that just disregard that.
Whether it stays
that
or not, I don't know. But
just
I really
disregard that
it.
Viewers. He's going to do it today.
Yeah,
right.
I'm going to do it today. I'm going to give this 93%. Guys, I think this is great.
I'll give it 90%. I'm not sure if I'm going to use it, but no, I won't use it, actually. So I should give it 89. Scribble that out, put 89, John. But I do really like it. In Woody's
and you can
hands,
see it working for a lot of people.
In Woody's hands and a lot of people's hands, this is probably the most commercial packet card trick I've seen.
And you know what? I would agree with that. There's a quote. The most commercial packet card trick I have ever seen.
Yeah, for a family audience.
Had to kind of put that in at the end, didn't you?
Right, so last week we mentioned a competition to win a lifetime subscription to Real Magic Online.
And this is really great. Real Magic Online, basically, you get access to all of the old Real Magic magazines. He's putting new content up all the time. He's just done some stuff with Eric Jones and Garrett Thomas. He's putting new content up, all the new magazines that come up. You get access to everything. It's a great deal in Magic right now. This, and we're giving you a chance to win a lifetime
this
membership.
This is what you have to do to win. It's a competition exclusive to Wizard Product Review viewers. All you have to do is go to our Facebook page. First of all, you have to hit like. You have to like World Magic Shop. So go to facebook.com/World Magic Shop. And at 12 o'clock GMT on the Wednesday, we will have posted a link to this video like we do every Wednesday at 12 o'clock. Underneath that video in the comments, what you have to do is write your best experience of real magic.
Did you come up with this or did Cos?
No, I came up with it.
Really?
Yeah.
It sounds like the sort of thing Cos would come up
so
with.
So for me, it was, you know, the first time I saw Tommy Wonder and I was his volunteer with the cups and balls at the Blackpool Magic Convention. And for me, that was just bang, you know. A close second to that would be Mark Raffles. who had this beautiful effect where he used to, this one of my favourite, probably the most favourite bit of stage magic I ever saw. IBM competition, walked down into the stalls. He said to the lady, hold on to the handkerchief. And he said to her, look at it on both sides. So she went like this and he just gathered it up and there was a dove. And the whole audience of magicians gasped.
You know,
and the reason was, it was just such a beautiful piece of real magic because it was so simple.
Yeah.
He wasn't out there busting loads of moves. He just went, can I take that? And there was the dove. It was brilliant.
You've put me on the spot here because I didn't know about this competition. Do you remember at Magic Live, we went to see the Carnival of Wonders?
Yes.
Do you remember, well, the whole Carnival of Wonders, but do you remember that opening illusion?
Where the poster came
he had
life.
A poster, and I just was just freaking out next to you. My glasses were falling off. I was just freaking out. There was a poster. He was carrying a poster. He just laid the poster out, and then Jeff Hobson came to life.
And it did look like that.
It was the most amazing thing, and still is the most amazing thing I've ever seen. And then the clothes, where everything just goes down into the suitcase, and he walks up. I've still got... That is the best show... you know, I love the Carnival when Mark Kalin, Ginger, Jeff Hobson. They are absolutely genius.
There's so many things. Everybody's got their own experience of real magic. So a magician that they saw and they still think back to it today. And we're just interested to find out what everybody... It doesn't matter if you put the same thing. We'll put you all into a draw and we'll let Coz judge it over FaceTime and we'll try and film it for the Wizard product review or
Sounds
something.
Good.
Should we try and do that?
Sounds good.
Okay, so that'll be in 2 weeks' time now. So you've got 2 weeks to get your comments on that show.
Anyway, you said you were going to do a trick that you spent half an hour that's going to eclipse what I just did with the bumblebees.
It's coming up right now. Are you ready for this, Craig?
I'm ready.
You see that point of the table just in front of me there, that glass bit of table?
Yeah, I see that glass bit.
Can you just tap it for me?
Do you don't want to?
No, you just tap it. Just, is that solid?
It's very solid,
It's absolutely solid. John, can we get it off the sticks?
Yeah.
And don't get too close. Just stay a little bit further. That is solid, isn't it, Craig?
It's solid.
So, right, you ready for this? Here we go. Right, you ready? Check it out. Look at that, Craig.
I'm looking.
Give it out. Look, hang on. Look. Thank you very much.
Oh my God. It's going to be one of these again, isn't it? Brilliant.
Imagine doing that in Subway, John.
Oh, good grief.
Awesome.
Good grief. This is just ridiculous. Come on, Dave.
Absolutely awesome.
How can anybody, like... Did you see... come on, Dave.
Great.
It's not great. Dave, when are you going to do that? When are you going to... Your baguette's drooping. When are you going to...
Just dampen.
I'll use that.
No, you won't use that. What?
I'll do that.
You're not going to use that.
Imagine
Dave,
in Subway.
Nobody is going
to... You know when they say...
You're going to walk into Subway with
I go
that
to Subway,
set up.
Down at Star City. I go there, Subway, you know. Brilliant, you know. Can we do... You know. What role do you want?
Dave,
just pull it out like
nobody
that.
Nobody is
just
that
gonna,
sad.
People are just going to... They'll freak.
You're going to walk around.
They will freak out.
You're going to set yourself up all day, just on the off chance that you might
do
go
it,
into Subway.
You could do a shopping tour. So
will you guys stop winding me up? This
brilliant.
Is the electric dove all over again. Just
I'll give
stop
him that
it.
98%.
Don't.
How much are you going to give it?
Don't.
How much are you going to give it?
Don't pee on our
no,
review
John,
ratings.
John, what are you going to give that? That's brilliant.
Don't you even,
I'd
Dave.
The reactions are
John,
amazing.
Don't.
I'd be 98, 99, 99.
It's awesome.
Don't do it. Don't do it.
Look
don't
how authentic it looks as well. It's real. I've got to tell you, right, let's just for review purposes,
bit of bread and
this is actually a gimmick. This is not a genuine baguette. I think it's fair to mention that for review purposes. You come with a gimmick, so you've got to, you know, you can do the moves quite easily.
Billets bought separately.
Yeah, but this is not a genuine baguette. This is a brilliant gimmick.
I refuse to rate this. This is absolutely stupid that we're looking at this. This
it's awesome.
Is
get
the
great reactions.
You know what? This
how
is,
much are you gonna give it?
I'm gonna give it 0% because it's just ridiculous. It is the worst thing I've ever seen. You can't do it closer.
No, it's not the worst thing you've seen. Eye floaters, you know.
Yeah.
It's look, look, you're not going to do it close up, you're not going to do it kids, you're not going to do it stage, it's got
TV,
no purpose at all.
TV, glass window, through subway.
Yeah.
Have somebody inside the window with a baguette and it coming out the other side.
Really?
It's awesome.
It's not awesome. It's not awesome.
So what's the best thing we've seen? Best thing
Come
we've seen
back,
this week?
Shin Lim, all is forgiven.
Well, I know you like the bumblebee thing, that's such visual magic at his best. But that's it this week for the Wizard product review. Don't forget to comment at facebook.com/worldmagicshop. What was your experience of real magic? Until next week.
It wasn't the baguette.
Until
I'll tell you
next
right
week.
Now, it wasn't the damn baguette.
People are going to put that on there.
Do not somebody, put that on there.
Somebody will put that as real magic. I'm Dave.
Whatever. I'm Craig.
See you next week.
That's brilliant.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah, brilliant. Do it again.
Can't do it again.